God, Father of all mankind, and judge over the nation. We pray thee to bless this memorial service and look down with favor and understanding on the hearts of those who are gathered here to pay tribute to those who made the supreme sacrifice. And for the benefit of all free men everywhere, the lives of those who made the supreme sacrifice are glorious before us. Their deeds constitute a daily inspiration for those like ourselves who remain in their home communities. In God we trust, and may the faith of our fathers guide, protect, and sustain our people. Amen.
Amen.
In April of 1945, captain of the
1820. Bill through 35 missions from England to Germany, including the February 3rd, 1945 bombing of Berlin. Columbus did his way to single park. Air Force in 2012 and 2013. On September 13, 2013, Bill was awarded France's highest award, the Legion of Honor Medal, for his service in World War II in defense of France. Grew up in Westfield, Mass. He attended Wesleyan public schools. Upon graduation, he enlisted in the U.S. Navy. After basic training, he became a member of a construction battalion known as the Seagulls. His naval service spanned 32 years, during which he attained the rank of master chief. He served tours of duty in Korea and Vietnam with naval construction. During his career, he attended Navy nuclear power reactor training at the South Pole, PM3A nuclear power plant. He holds an associate degree in civil engineering and construction management. He served on the Chief Petty Officer's Advisory Board, the Chief of Naval Operations Admiral Zumba. In 1979, he was selected to serve as the Force Master Chief and Commander of the Construction Battalion, U.S. Following retirement, he served as Lieutenant Colonel at Westfield State College. He has been active in the Disabled American Veterans Society and is currently Department Senior Vice Commander. Please welcome. Yeah.
heroism, sacrifice, and reflect of our nation's history book will be inundated in the counts of bravery that resonate with the nation. We are humbled by the tremendous courage and brave nature of our airmen, Marines, Coast Guard, Robert. There is no doubt that our ex-presidents have paved the way for our military finest fighting force in the world, both in strength and in charity. That's why it's important to have to be prepared and be always remembered. Almost 150 years ago, President Abraham Lincoln stood before a forward-weary nation and uttered the most famous words ever said about it. Lincoln spoke of the safety of our nation of our nation. Here for him, he shall have borne the battle for his widow and his orphan. These words are inscribed on the head of the Department of Veterans Affairs in our nation's capital. Every Memorial Day, Veterans Day event. We know that honoring our veterans with words alone falls short of the natural burden of life. By honoring them equally, we are worthy of their sacrifice. We all want for this place to be more beneficial in all of life than God our family. What more can we do to honor their life? How can we give them something more than eternal in the moment we're in? For some, victory are given in their life. Honor and acceptance is all they ask. So public ceremonies provide recognition of their service. But we have both the power and the obligation to do more for our veterans, for their family, their survivors. We must keep all of our promises to the veterans. We swore on oath to support and defend the Constitution of the United States against all enemies. We made a commitment to all. And at the same time, we as a nation bear a sacred obligation to them. On their return home, heal their wounds, rebuild their lives. Over the years, our government has worked with both the left on sacrificing healthcare, compensation, transition services, and other benefits in exchange for the year. However, time and again, especially in recent years, we've seen how partisan bickering and political gridlock threatens the ability of the Department of Veterans Affairs to meet the needs of our nation. Failure of Congress and presidency to assure sufficient, timely, predictable funds has will condition the half of the VA has promised. Just as we saw in October, the march of battle is leading to reach the stalemate to meet the cost of the Minnesota grant. That's why disabled American veterans and other veterans organizations have worked tirelessly. Legislation to provide sustained funding for veterans for the veterans of the year. As a result of that law, VA hospitals and clinics were able to remain open and provide medical care to the veterans during the shutdown. Well, that law has been a tremendous success for health care. It doesn't cover all of the VA funding. There are still important parts of the veterans administration that have struck a political stalemate and blocked the budget. As was demonstrated during the shutdown, the VA did not process the disability claim, and many critical services were hampered. The shutdown had just continued a full 2 weeks longer. The VA would not have been able to make the mandatory benefit to disabled veterans, student veterans, and survivors. We can never allow this to happen again. The men and women who put their lives on the line never have to worry whether they will be sick or live. And that's why the disabled American veterans color brothers are working together to get the privilege of the our new brothers mentioned in Capitol Hill earlier this year, they're operating the people's lives. That's why we've engaged millions of Americans in this conversation, Facebook, Twitter, and other social networks. It's a conversation that needs to happen in the communities across this country. Every voter in America has a vote. Every voter in America has a voice.
Operate to just